welcome to this time of prayer on this Friday as we anticipate tomorrow's feast of George Herbert, priest and poet. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Hear my prayer, O Lord, and hear my cry. Hold not your peace at my tears. Jesus, like a mother, you gather your people to you. You are gentle with us as a mother with her children. Despair turns to hope through your sweet goodness. Through your gentleness, we find comfort in fear. Your warmth gives life to the dead. Your touch makes sinners righteous. Lord Jesus, in your mercy, heal us. In your love and tenderness, remake us. In your compassion, bring grace and forgiveness. For the beauty of heaven, may your love prepare us. The psalm appointed for today is Psalm 32, verses 1 to 8. Be glad, you righteous, and rejoice in the Lord. Happy the one whose transgression is forgiven and whose sin is covered. Happy the one to whom the Lord imputes no guilt and in whose spirit there is no guile. For I held my tongue, and my bones wasted away through my groaning all the day long. Your hand was heavy upon me day and night. My moisture was dried up like a drought in the summer. Then I acknowledged my sin to you, and my iniquity I did not hide. I said, I will confess my transgressions to the Lord, and you forgave the guilt of my sin. Therefore let all the faithful make their prayers to you in time of trouble. In the great water flood it shall not reach them. You are a place for me to hide in. You preserve me from trouble. You surround me with songs of deliverance. Be glad, you righteous, and rejoice in the Lord. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. World without end. Amen. Our reading today is taken from the Gospel of St. Matthew. At that time Jesus said, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent, and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart. And you will find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. This is the word of the Lord. Let all the world in every corner sing, My God and King. One of the most recognisable hymns that we sing in our churches. Written, of course, by the great George Herbert, priest and poet. George Herbert was born in Montgomery, Wales on April the 3rd in the year 1593. He was born into a noble family. He was educated at Westminster School and Trinity College, Cambridge. He was elected public orator. It was a post carrying dignity and even some authority. Its incumbent was called on to express in the florid Latin of the day the sentiments of the university on public occasions. He was also elected to represent Montgomery in Parliament. And in the year 1626, at the death of Sir Francis Bacon, who had dedicated a translation of Psalms to Herbert the year before, he contributed a memorial poem in Latin. Herbert could have used his post of orator to reach high political office, but instead he gave up his secular ambitions and took holy orders. And in the year 1630, he was ordained and spent the rest of his life as rector in Bemerton near Salisbury. He served faithfully as a parish priest, diligently visiting his parishioners and bringing them the sacraments when they were ill, and food and clothing when they were in want. He read morning and evening prayer daily in the church, encouraging the congregation to join him when possible, and ringing the church bell before each service so that those who could not come might hear it and pause in their work to join their prayers with his. He was a great parish priest, and he was loved dearly by his congregation. Today, of course, he's remembered chiefly as a poet, and his poems, still in print to this day, are very much about devotion to God. And of course, as I said, many have become hymns that we sing today. We remember him chiefly as a poet and a hymn writer, but we remember a diligent priest who was faithful to his people and faithful to God. Amen. We now have a time of intercession. We pray for God's grace. Lord, receive our praise and hear our prayer. Lord God, through your grace we are your people. Through your Son you have redeemed us. In your Spirit you have made us your own. We pray for the Alfred Jewell benefice and for all whom we live and work amongst. May our hearts respond to your love. May we, as we journey through Lent, come closer to you through the words of people like George Herbert and those people that have gone before us. We pray for those in our community who suffer, and we ask, Lord, that you make us mindful of them, that we may seek them out, and that during this time of reflection, as we come closer to the cross and the salvation, you may bless us in faith and in love. The Collect for George Herbert. King of glory, King of peace, who called your servant George Herbert from the pursuit of worldly honours to be a priest in the temple of his God and King, grant us also the grace to offer ourselves with singleness of heart in humble obedience to your service, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and for ever. Amen. And may God's blessing rest upon us and all whom we love and care for, this day and evermore. Amen.